biotech. Sounds futuristic, but it's been part of our culture for a very long time, and it might just be the answer to the climate and biodiversity crisis that threatens our very existence. But how do we revive our exhausted soil, restore our forests, clean our rivers and oceans, remove greenhouse gases from the atmosphere? Technology has transformed living standards across the world. It's also been a major driver of climate change. But the same tools that contributed to the crisis may also hold the key to solving it. Perhaps we just need to see technology through a different lens. What if technology worked with nature?
Nature is really fascinating in the way that it has all these solutions to pressing issues that humanity is facing today.
What if technology was part of nature?
Nature-based solutions were the original technology. We're just now beginning to realize it and use it.
Could a different type of technology be the answer to the crisis we're facing?
We're in a biotech revolution.
This is biotechnology. Okay, before we go any further, let's define our terms. Biotech is using living cells and bacteria to make things.
We are utilizing a technology that has existed for thousands of years. Bacteria have done their thing on this earth for a long time, and we're taking that ability and creating something with it.
When farmers selectively bred their crops or used fermentation to make cheese, they were shaping biology to meet human needs. This is biotech in its earliest form, using living systems to solve problems. Things accelerated in the 20th century. In the 1970s, scientists developed the tools to splice DNA, giving rise to genetic engineering. By the 1990s, pest-resistant crops were being planted on industrial scales. Today, the field has evolved further. We can edit genes with precision, program microbes to produce fuel and eat plastic, and even design new organisms. We can think of it as a toolkit that uses living things rather than the living things themselves. One form of biotechnology can look very different from another. It all depends on its purpose. It can use living organisms, like bacteria, fungi, or plants. Parts of living organisms, like enzymes, or even biological processes to achieve its end goal. The way we use biotech is incredibly varied, and it might have a major part to play in creating a better future for us all. Farming is perhaps the original biotech and has had a major impact on the planet. Not only is it a major source of greenhouse gas emissions, it's also one of the sectors most affected by them. Fyteko's biostimulants help plants cope with the stresses associated with climate change by encouraging them to be more tolerant and adaptable.
In our case, we really focus on drought and heat waves, which are often combined. We really work with a single active ingredient, a single molecule, which is active in any part of the crop. So you can apply it on the canopy, on the seed, or even on the root system in the soil. So you can actually trigger the natural mechanism that all plants have and, let's say, enable the full genetic potential of the crop. So it's actually helping the crop to really induce its natural mechanism of defense.
Illinois-based LanzaTech have been exploring the role biotech can play in dealing with waste emissions. Their work has led to an ingenious solution, not only engineering microbes that capture carbon from industrial waste gases, but also converting it into products like jet fuel, fabrics, and packaging.
I imagine a future where a waste gas at a steel mill can be the dash in a car. A future where a steel mill gas can be a pair of running shorts. These are the things we're imagining. But more importantly, these are the things we're making possible. We're already doing it.
Meanwhile, elsewhere in Illinois, Mycocycle are using biotech to explore the miraculous properties of mycelium, the underground root network of fungi.
Fungi are fantastic. They are the ultimate alchemist of this planet. Mycelium are great at decomposing constituents out in nature that are very hard to break down. And we can translate those properties into decomposing construction waste. We teach the mycelium to eat trash by exposing little bits at a time until the mycelium has developed an affinity for these materials.
This biotech doesn't just break down waste, it converts it into new fungi-based biomaterial with a range of uses, including insulation and packaging.
There is no waste in nature. There's always someone else, something else that takes advantage of the byproducts of any process.
There's interest in actually taking mycelium beyond manufactured materials. So it's this network of living material that actually could provide a solution for batteries, for moving electronics around, for acting as a sensor within responsive systems. So the potential of mycelium is huge.
So mushrooms into materials, and maybe more. But could biotech be used to create durable, low-carbon alternatives to high-impact construction materials like concrete? In other words,
can we grow a building? My vision for biotechnology in the built environment is the idea where all the components of a building could be grown rather than relying on the extractive processes that we look to at the moment.
In North Carolina, Biomason are imitating coral formations to produce biocement, without the extreme heat or emissions associated with traditional concrete production.
We are able to harness the power of bacteria that's been doing its thing for thousands of years underneath the sea in caves to generate biocement.
So the starting point for our biocement is our bacteria. We grow it in our lab and stabilize it. We then add it to our aggregate. We feed it with our calcium and the nutrients to help the bacteria live. And 72 hours later, we have a solid unit.
And I think that that's where we can make the biggest difference is to use something natural and put it into our built world.
So Biomason is rethinking our built world. But how does biotech apply to the resources that sustain it? Swedish firm Retein is developing transformational biotech that could help clean polluted water while simultaneously recovering valuable resources such as lithium, a vital component of modern technology whose limited supplies have traditionally been extracted through destructive methods.
Water purification today uses quite a lot of energy, and it's not highly precise in the way that nature is. Nature has this ability to combine energy efficiency with high precision in recovering resources from water mixtures. We're looking to bring nature's finest separation technology, which is happening in the cell membrane of every living cell, into filtration.
Retein has found a way to use a protein called aquaporin in a membrane that filters out impurities and retains materials that would otherwise go to waste. Aquaporins are normally incredibly fragile, but Retein has found a way to stabilize them with a silica-based shell that improves their durability. So biotech can scale nature's recycling systems for industrial use, grow bricks with bacteria, and engineer protein to prevent pollution. And that's just the start. It's also producing plastic-eating microbes, light-powered carbon-negative chemistry from companies like New Iridium, lab-grown meat and bioactive pouches that extend the lifespan of fresh fruit and vegetables at Green Pod Labs. Biotech could help solve some of the biggest problems we face, but it also raises questions. Engineered microbes don't always behave as expected. Ecosystems are complex, and solving environmental problems with new technologies can sometimes create new risks. But despite these challenges, biotech could still be one of the most powerful tools we have.
It's really about us learning and collecting and understanding and utilizing those lessons and learnings into biotechnology.
What we're really interested in doing is connecting industries. So not to think about this kind of silo of a construction industry and a biotech industry, but actually how can these big key industries work together?
Together, we're learning how to work with biology rather than against it, to respect nature rather than abuse it. It might not be the whole solution, but with research and time, biotech could become a key part of the answer to the world's greatest problems. The science of using life itself as a tool, programming cells, harnessing microbes, and designing new materials to meet human and planetary needs. It's powerful, it's complex, and it's evolving all the time. That's biotechnology.